Georgia. We on the grind in Georgia. All the time. It ain't nothing on my mind, but Georgia. We ain't playing with you. We on the. Hey, g'day, Sebastien. How are you?
Hey, I'm good, Peter. How are you?
Fantastic. Welcome, everybody. I'm on the line here with Sebastien Brault, who's the CEO of Wingocard. I'm Peter Hazlehurst, CEO and founder of Synctera. And what we're talking a little bit about today is how do banking partnerships work for fintechs, and what's some strategies that you can use to be more successful and build faster, ship faster, get the best price, all that sort of thing. As a sort of a recap, my company, Synctera, focuses on building that bridge between both sides of the marketplace, fintechs like Sebastien's and banks like CFSB, who is one of our partner banks. And our goal is to help everybody get to market as quickly as possible, build the least amount of stuff that they don't have to, and then focus in on creating value for everyone, particularly the consumers that are served by each different fintech. So as a starting point, Sebastien, do you want to tell us a little bit about Wingocard and what you guys do and who your customers are and that sort of thing?
Sure. So Wingocard is a company that we launched in early 2020. It came from the idea of, you know, helping parents and teens manage money in a better way. Essentially, our solution is a mobile banking app that is designed specifically for teens and parents. The app comes with a Visa debit card, and it allows parents to essentially send money to their teens very easily from anywhere. Teens can pay with their card or with their mobile phone, online, offline, anywhere where Visa is accepted. Teens can also, you know, track and better understand their spending, which is very important to create better habits, spending habits. And they no longer have to rely on their parents' credit card to spend online, which is, for us parents, fantastic.
I'm a parent, Sebastien. We talked about this a little bit. It feels like sort of like a bit of like screen time for your iPhone, where you can set rules for what you can spend on. Like my son, if I gave him access to my credit card, there'd be $1,000 of Robux every week. How do the controls work? Can people do that sort of thing?
Well, so essentially the first thing starts with the budget, you know, that you allocate to your son. So if you give your son, for example, $20 or $15 to play with, you know that he'll be capped at this amount. And it's better to, you know, play with a smaller amount and learn to manage your money with smaller amounts than to actually, you know, have like no limits on your parents' credit card. So that's the simple foundation for that.
I love that. It's a constant struggle as a parent, sort of balancing like how much free time, how much money, all that sort of stuff. So anything you can do to help teach them, and my daughter too, she'd be playing Roblox as well. That'd be great. So when you started on this journey of building the Wingocard, how did you figure out what sort of tech you're going to use, and what were the things that you considered as you're making decisions on which platforms, what strategies, and so forth?
Yeah, so we have a very strong entrepreneurial / tech background, but we were a little light on the fintech side, so we had to do a lot of research to better understand this complex ecosystem. Depending on what you're trying to build, you need to have a lot of vendors involved. So the first thing that we did, you know, we did a lot of research and we established what were our priorities as a company to build this app. And for us, you know, it was get to market as fast as possible. We wanted to maximize our potential revenues. When we talk about interchange, for example, depending on the negotiations that you'll have, you'll keep more or less of the interchange, which can be a significant revenue channel. We wanted to obviously minimize the cost. We wanted to own, like for us, we wanted to own the relationship with some of the more strategic partners and vendors. And finally, we were looking for providers, for vendors that could service us in our two main markets, which is first US and second Canada. How we went about it is we first really look at what was the stack, right? So for us, building a neobank for parents and teens, the core components were essentially we needed a sponsoring bank, we needed an issuing partner, we needed an acquiring processor. We needed an ACH processor, KYC or CIP vendor. So lots of vendors. And finally, you know, card vendor and compliance and AML specialists.
In all of this vendor management, did you find yourself by default becoming an expert in different pricing models and all of that stuff? Or was it all straightforward and it's just the slam dunk, was easy?
It's funny that you asked me this. It's as if you read my notes. So one of the most complicated things, okay, to do when we were negotiating these contracts was to understand their pricing. Each one of those vendors have very different and some very exotic pricing. So just to wrap your head around all of that is very time consuming and very painful. And it's very hard to compare one vendor with another vendor because they all have a different model. So yeah, lots of work that needed to be done on that front for sure.
So you ended up with Community Federal Savings Bank, CFSB, which is also a partner with us at Synctera. How did you find them and why pick them?
So for us, the way we went about it is, you know, one of our advisors very early on suggested that we apply to Visa Fast Track, which we did. And it was very helpful because Visa introduced us to a bunch of potential vendors that we could work with, that they had worked with in the past and that they vetted. So that helped us really narrow our potential vendor list. And after that, the core vendor for us was really anything processing, because all the other vendors need to play very well with your processing partner. So once, you know, we had our issuing processor, then, you know, we went on to all the different partners, and the next one was CFSB, and essentially that issuing partner, presented us with multiple choices in terms of banks. We did our due diligence, we did reference checks, we negotiated, and at the end, CFSB was like super reactive, very competitive. And, you know, we decided to go with them.
Got it. And Howard and the gang there have run bunches of different programs and stuff like that. Did it feel like they were coaching you on how to do it? Or did you feel like you were, hey, I've got this really crazy new thing, let me tell you what we need to do? How was the partnership? Was it collaborative? Was it someone teaching the other? How did it feel?
It was very collaborative. And in the case of Howard, he was super helpful because, again, we were green coming into fintech. So he was one of the people that we spoke to that made it like, you know, very, really vulgarized what needed to be done from a stack point of view. After that, what we were building, there was a lot of discovery still. It was a new product. There weren't that many offering like that in the market. So a lot of people were learning as we were going and as we were building this, for sure.
How would you, I mean, there are a couple of others. CJ runs a company called Step. And my friend also runs a company called Greenlight. How would you compare yourselves to those different sorts of platforms for the consumer? What's the delta for you?
So, first, if we think about Greenlight instead, Greenlight is really coming from an approach where they're targeting parents and kids. So their branding and their offering is really about allowances and, you know, really controlling the spending of your kids. Where Greenlight is going more, where Step is more about, teens, like us at the end of the day. So we're both building a teen brand and essentially going after the teens first and building features for teens and parents second. Obviously, the parents are super important in this equation because we all share the passion of helping the next generation become smarter with money. And this is great because we don't need to have the exclusivity of this. The more we are working at this, the more we are helping these young teens become, you know, savvy young adults and not get into the same pitfalls as previous generations. So I would position Greenlight, parents and kids. Step is older teens, 16, 17 and up, and we're targeting 14 and plus. So that's pretty much how we would compare.
Got it. That sounds great. How would you think about, 7 months later, when did you start? I can't remember, a year
ago. So we started early 2020. We started the company, but we really got started working on the product itself, like around March. It took us quite a while to negotiate the partners. Like, that was a big chunk just going through the contracts. These are very heavy contracts, 5-year contracts, and costly when you come from a startup point of view. On day one, you know, there's a lot of money to be spent.
That's okay. No, I think it's really interesting. So you've been sort of building, give or take, a bit over a year.
Yes.
Do you think, so it's 2021, crazy new companies like Synctera and Unit are out there basically offering no more need to negotiate every partner and all that sort of stuff. We'll give you best of breed solutions. How do you feel like would you be doing things differently today than you were a year ago? Or do you think your path was the right path or it's working for you?
So it's early to say what we would be doing differently and not, because again, the fact that we are our own program manager for us meant that we were lowering costs and mm-hmm. increasing our commission. One thing is for sure, we would raise more money. Building a neobank is costly and time consuming. Yeah. But to answer your question, absolutely. If we would have found a partner in those days that would have prevented us from having to negotiate with the bank, and if they would have already had the relationship with the bank and we just could have come in and trusted that partner to do a good job, that would have been amazing. Another thing for us today is, like, we're super happy about CFSB and our partnership with them, but it's a single point of failure for us. We need to have a backup plan, and we've already invested a lot of money, and now we're going to have to go in the market sooner than later and find a second bank to make sure that whatever happens in the market, are we secure, because all our business is dependent on this one bank. So
yeah. I've heard that a lot from the savvy fintech founders that get going with a pilot, get their first set of customers, and then realize, hey, hang on a second, how do we deal with if something goes wrong and multitasking or multipathing the transactions and so forth? So that's definitely something top of mind. Anyway, listen, thank you so much, Sebastien, for the great, great insights. I know we're super excited to be partnering with you and helping you out, and look forward to expanding our relationship. And I'm really excited to be able to soon announce a whole bunch of new banks on the platform to give founders like you a bunch of choice of who to bank with and how to go to market. Maybe a closing comment would be, I'm sort of curious, what do you do for fun?
What do I do for fun? For fun, I like to kite surf. I like to play music with my son. My son is a young singer songwriter, so I help him out.
Fantastic.
Yeah. And hey, by the way, Peter, likewise, I just wanted to say, I'm really looking forward to working with the reconciliation product that we're currently integrating. That's going to be fantastic. I mean, this is the kind of work that we don't have the bandwidth for and takes a lot away. And same thing for the ledger. Like, this is a feature that we would have to wait at least 12 more months to have if we can work with you guys. So super excited also.
Fabulous. Yeah, we're going to keep building and team's growing. Sounds like you're making great progress. Congrats on your recent fundraise and look forward to seeing amazing progress from you. That's
Thank
it
you.
From us here. Thank you. Georgia, we on the grind, Georgia.